Hello family, and I'm coming back to you with another video. Just as I promised, I'm gonna be in and out with doing these videos, okay? Because I ain't got shit to do and I want to talk. But I did get a chance to definitely cook my Sunday meal, me and my mom down there, and my daughter's washing dishes as we go along. But I just wanted to get this quick little story out that I saw came across my media feed from Celebrity Insider. Yes, they say Andy Cohen confirms that the Real Housewives of Atlanta reunion is postponed due to the coronavirus outbreak. Like, damn, first the queen leave her castle, okay? Then they bogart us when not having no toilet paper to wash our behinds. And damn sure didn't have a great meat selection out there. But it was okay. I muddled through it all, okay? Now they're trying to take Real Housewives of Atlanta. Bravo, what y'all doing? What are y'all doing out there? This coronavirus is taking over everything, okay? I don't know what we're going to do if they take the television and the phones from us and the internet. I think we'll just be out there parading in the street talking about we want our rights. We want our rights. I know that's right because I'll be out there with them because you know I'm a talk and I like to talk. Even if I have to say I'm talking bullshit, okay? But that's how I get down with my family, all right? But anyway, let's go on and get into why Andy Cohen and the coronavirus is making us all unhappy these days, okay? We got the article written up by Alexis Stone, correspondent over there at Celebrity Insider. And let's see what she has to say within her article, okay? It says, Andy Cohen just confirmed to the Real Housewives of Atlanta fans that the reunion has been postponed to the coronavirus outbreak. All right, the World Health Organization, that's who, WHO, that's my sidebar, because half the time they don't spell it out, it just says who, H-O. I mean, WHO, World Health Organization, just for my family that didn't know when they be using all these abbreviations, because, you know, sometimes I had to come to y'all and ask y'all, what this shit mean, okay? Is it the younger generation trying to get one up on me just because I'm OG? What does this mean, okay? So I thought I'd throw one out at y'all. But anyway, going back to the article, it says the World Health Organization declared the coronavirus outbreak a pandemic, okay? And this boosted fear and uncertainty all over the globe. Yes, okay? People talk about Kenya Moore in the comments with some haters bashing her and fans coming in her defense. Someone said, now Kenya has more time to perfect these lies and fake tears. So I'm like, okay, I hear you. Yeah, she need to get it on board. She need to cry when it's time to cry and when it's time to lie, know when to lie, okay? Because all that shit is catching up with her. That's my sidebar. That's not in this article, okay? Going back to the article, it says, a follower posted this. People say that, but she's back, and the show still doesn't catch anyone's interest like that. The show is still the same with or without her. The show has already reached its peak seasons ago. And I agree. I think we need some new heads up in there. We sure do. We need to bump Cynthia to the side. We need to have Kenya and Nene come on as guest appearances. We need to get rid of Candy, find somebody for her spot. I did say we need to get rid of Cynthia, okay, yeah. And then she have a nerd talking about she finna revamp or reintroduce her eyewear line to us. I'm like, what? I said, Frost, I know they were selling on Amazon and eBay. Girl, they weren't even in the stores. And you talking about you finna re-establish something? I'm like, Cynthia, sit down, okay? Do makeup. Since you always in this hair, do makeup. I think that will probably be more winning for you than anything else. Because that luggage, it was already overpriced and not even looking like, you know, something that you really want to put your valuables in. It was just like something you would buy at Walmart. Same thing with your eyeglasses that you were selling. They really look like they can go for 24, maybe 50. You were trying to put them at 300. I'm like, girl, bye. But anyway, that was my sidebar. Going back to the article, it says a follower posted this. People say that she's back and the show still doesn't catch anyone's interest like that. The show is still the same with or without her. The show has already reached its peak seasons ago. One other commenter said, last season was lame. Pretty much any season without her is boring. And that's just the honest truth. Okay. Then we got Someone else wrote, I'm telling y'all, it's a low-class society of black edgeless women attacking Kenya. She got the nerve to call Kenya a lie, but Nene was in like 2 episodes and has lied 3 or 4 times. Now, I'm going to just do my sidebar. No, it's not low-class society, black edgeless people attacking Kenya. Because you can probably put Kenya in that same boat that this commenter is saying prior to her getting to Real Housewives of Atlanta. Everything stepped up. When she started appearing several episodes and seasons on Real Housewives of Atlanta, her hair, her makeup, her look, her stylist, everything changes. But that's the whole old adage. They say when you got money, money brings better things to you, okay? Because you can afford better things than working what you were doing prior to getting on the show. So that's just a myth in general. Money can make the ugliest person look good, okay? Check out Biggie Smalls. Now, I ain't saying he was ugly, but I'm saying he wasn't that attractive when he was just some old Joe Blow. But when he blew up, he dressed up and money made him look good, okay? I'm just saying. But anyway, that's my sidebar. Going back to the article, it said a follower posted, Kenya never lies. The liar on the show was Phaedra. She's gone. I'm like, honey, commenter, we want Phaedra back. Everybody in their time have lied, okay? Let someone that's without sin cast the first stone. You see what I'm saying? I've lied. You've lied. Everybody's lied. Whether it's a white little lie or whether it's a humongous mega lie. A lie is a lie in a lie, okay? But anyway, that was just my sidebar again. You know I have many when I'm doing my commentary. Okay, but it says another commenter said, I'm sorry that it causes you so much pain. No one said anything about Kenya's looks, so it must bother you that she's beautiful. Okay, now you know people. When they can't go for something that they really want to go for, people tend to go for people's looks. It's a known thing. But when you got thick skin, you don't care, you don't clot your own teeth, it still doesn't penetrate. But that's usually what low-minded people do think, okay? They think if they can attack, they can't attack your character, they can't attack for what you stand for, they go for your looks. That's just an old dirty trick that's never been gotten rid of. It's tried and true. But it only works for people that are not into themselves and know who they are, okay? But anyway, moving on, that's just my sidebar. Another fans believe that clearly Kenya is doing something right. She has all of you haters hot and bothered. Instead of worrying about your bank account, you are here hating on another black woman who's clearly doing a very good job getting you in your feelings and collecting her coins. You might want to do the same because you're looking really thirsty and broke. To that commenter, I just want to say, no, you need to get a break, okay? Because while you're on this platform telling other people how they should feel about said person that's on their TV screen, that is hypocrisy in this big old ugly rear head. You can't come out in the public eye, say this, that, and the third, and you don't think somebody's going to have an opinion. I mean, really, is that what we got into? Yeah, here you go. My mom's in here bothering me while I'm taping. But okay, that's what I'm saying. People get on these different reality shows and you all hold them as gods or goddesses and stuff. And it's not true. They're people who have been pimped out. They chose to abandon their professional careers because being an entertainer or just in the entertainment industry is more lucrative for them. And they don't have to really do anything. They don't really have to have a true thought. They can say whatever and then you got people believing in them. I'm like, how am I mindless is that? We are all falling short when we're all looking at the reality shows that they give us. We already know the premises of their platform is to just entertain us. But to people that sit up here and ride and die hard for people that they don't know, such as Kenya Moore, y'all don't know how that woman get down. Maybe a few know because they've sat in there, broken bread, would have been at a house, been around her, and know the real Kenya. The only thing we have to show is what Kenya shows on TV. And it's not very flattering, okay? So again, I tell you, please stop. If you're going to make an opinion on how somebody gives commentary or write up articles and put them in vlogs for us to view, keep your mouth closed, okay? Keep your mouth closed or make a comment and be gone with it, okay? Make your statement and be gone, but don't be trying to bash somebody because they're one of your favorites and somebody may be actually telling the truth about one of your favorites. Don't ride nobody coattail like that. If you know somebody is doing an offense, clock their teeth. Tell them, damn, why you acting like that? You don't act like this. When we're together, why you acting all crazy? Like you ain't got no sense. And they say, well, honey, I'm trying to do it for the dollar. I'm trying to be in this reality game. It pays. And then you want to say, okay, well, get off my friend. You know, no, your friend is out there acting an ass in public. And, of course, we're going to tell that person that they're acting an ass. People such as myself, a blogger, YouTube content creator, if you on my screen and you just acting all foul and I had my own expectations or example of how you should be acting, that's mean because you didn't tell me to have that about you. That was just me. So I got to call out my own to you. I shouldn't be watching your ass, but you give me drama and amusement sometimes. So what can I say? I'm in this twisted mix just like the rest of you all. Okay? But I'm just saying, all these people that's making all these comments to my, don't talk about them. You have no right to talk about them. Yes, we have a right. It's called freedom of speech. Okay? So sit down somewhere. All right, but that's just my sidebar. Going back to the article, it says someone says that Kenya is simply acting, and in real life she is completely a different person. See there? You see how that just spoke into fruition? But we don't know that side. We are not privy to that. So when you get in a ratchet type of a profession or field in the industry, we only going by what we see. So we'll hate, we'll love you, however the ball may fall. Take it, leave it, or you know, get out of your situation and get back to your career that you went to school for. Okay, that's all I gotta say. You're gonna have people love you, you're gonna have people hate you, and then you're gonna have the people that are just so indifferent, they don't know which way to go. That's just how it is. That's my sidebar. Moving back, it says you guys need to stop this. Kenya's acting. Producers tell you to be relevant to keep your job. Well, my sidebar, because you know I have a few when I'm doing commentary. If you want Kenya not to be got on, if we don't know the real Kenya that you do know, tell Kenya to get her ass off of Real Housewives of Atlanta. Then we won't have nothing to say because she won't be out there for us to say whether she's acting appropriate or not appropriate. If she wants to stay on this show, she wants to act a ratchet ass itch all the time, getting on people's nerves, that's what we're going to give her back. We're going to say, this is what you're doing, this is the part you're playing, and this is how we feel about it. Okay, we could care less about the real Kenya, as though Kenya don't really care about the real Kenya, because she cashing in on her cash cow, and that's Real Housewives of Atlanta. So don't get on us when we get on Kenya Moore or anybody else we feel like we want to get on that's addressing our screen and not doing what we feel they should be doing. Okay, you give her the same accolades and respect, please give us the same as well to voice our opinions. That's all I got to say. Moving back on to the article, it says Kenya is acting. Producers tell you to be relevant to keep your job. Kenya has to live, so she's bringing what TV wants. Okay, and what TV wants is for us to critique. So again, if we're allowing Kenya to act a fool up on this screen, then allow the bloggers, the YouTube content creators to express their opinions and get paid too. Okay, that's all I'm saying. It's tit for tat, it's tat for tit. Okay, get into it. All right, but anyway, we go back to the article. It says y'all don't know. Wait a minute. It says Kenya has to live, so she's bringing what TV wants. Y'all don't know this woman. My sister's Kenya's nanny. Kenya just bought her a new home. She's completely different in real life. Stop it, everybody. No, we won't stop it. Now, Kenya want to buy us a new home, a new car, whatever. Go on and do you, Kenya. But it makes us feel like she could do whatever she want to do. She could say whatever she want to say, and we're supposed to let it slide. No, we let her live. We let her do her commentary on TV. Then she need to let us live. Let us do our commentary on our YouTube or in our vlogging type formats, okay? Without any induction for any fans or foes that want to tell us what to do. Just like you ain't telling her what to do, don't tell us what to do. That's how I look at things, okay? So then it says, what do you think about people's debate in this comment? I think it was a great debate, and I think everybody has a right to express their opinions in a respectful way. But what I get mad at is when people try to tell you, don't get on their fave, you don't know what you're talking about, this, that, and the third. I could say the same about your person that you're taking up for. It's tit for tat. It's everybody trying to get paid. I'm telling you, YouTube content creators, unless you're on a very high platform and you can bring out breaking news that nobody has heard from, you are making pennies on a dollar. A dollar's on a penny. However that thing go, okay? I'm telling you, y'all think we make a hell of a lot of money, especially with the lower YouTubers. Now, we get paid when we get, you know, certain articles that go out there and people just really love. But the degree of that money goes down after 28 days, okay? And then we have to go for that next hit, hoping that we get a lot of people come in and do what they got to do. And our videos get shown a very vast amount if people like our videos. That's why people always say, like my videos, because YouTube has this algorithm, and if you get a certain amount of likes, they put you in a bigger platform that you can be seen all over the globe. Now, a lot of my videos have you can best be sure, has hit global status, okay? But it doesn't always rotate on every video I put out. You see what I'm saying? That's why people beg y'all to like. I don't want y'all to do it. Like it if you like it. If you don't like it, give me the thumbs down. I don't really pretty much give a shit. I like it because it gives me supplemental income, and I have come attached to some of my family members. And I love all of my family members, but sometimes they get out of pocket and they have to leave me for whatever reason. But I'm looking forward to build my channel with Ride or Dyers. You know what I'm saying? Ride or Dyers. Ride or Dyers. Y'all know what I'm saying, okay? I want people that's here to, you know, because they like my commentary. They like me and all that. And I'm going to keep giving it to you because I'm not one of those YouTubers that also say, oh, super chat me, or do all these other things where I'm asking y'all for money. Nah, because see, I know some of y'all Indian givers. Y'all don't like something I say. Y'all be like, give me a refund. I'm like, I ain't giving you nothing but my time. Now, I can never get that back from you all, and you can never get that back from me. So I just suggest, come on over to the family. Join in. Let's grow together. Let's do what we got to do. I hit that 10,000. I already said I'm going to have an event. Y'all got to come to Atlanta. Of course, y'all going to have to foot the bill, but I have y'all some drinks and food, and we can get out and chit-chat for a long spell. You know what I'm saying? Until the event hall has said you don't, you know, ranch your time unless you want to pay up some more money, then we got to go. We got to bounce, okay? So that's all in the works, but it's when I hit 10,000, okay? I'm just saying. Not putting no stress or no pressure on anybody. When nobody get there, we all still living after this coronavirus or any other virus they want to throw on us. You know what I'm saying? We can make it happen. But I'm not over here to cash out any money from y'all. And I damn sure ain't trying to get y'all no money unless I come into it and I just like somebody. And I said, damn, let me bless you. You know what I'm saying? I got blessed. Let me bless you type of scenario. But like I said, it just is what it is. I just like people to let people live. Let people have their own, say what they got to say. Just keep it on subject matter. Don't go get deep and try to get in folks' business and try to cuss them out because they ain't liking somebody you don't like. That's not how we do over here. Not the family. You can't be a part of the family. You got to come over here with attitude. You got to tell folks what to do, what they should be doing, or who they should be going for. Nah, that ain't your place. It ain't your business, okay? We just come over here and we congregate together. We talk shit about different subjects. You have your opinion, I have my opinion. Do they match all the time? Hell no. Okay, we got Kenya lovers, like I said, we got Nene lovers, we got Portia lovers, and I get on every last one of them. If they ain't doing something I feel they should be doing, or it's just total foul, you making me sick and I want to throw up on you, then I'm gonna call you a spade. Okay, ain't nobody saved. No, ain't nobody saved. And if your family member over here cutting up, then I gotta get in your ass too. I gotta get you straight, because I be wanting y'all to get me straight too, because y'all done told me several times, damn, you talk too damn long. Cut it up. Make it 15 to 20 minutes. And I've been trying. The time I go a little over, I know I understand. But I'm giving y'all great content. I tell you, take me in small doses. You can't get me all in that one session. Come back hell on your lunch break at night when you can't go to sleep. Shit, something like that. All right? But that's all I got to say, y'all. Y'all enjoy y'all break. Y'all enjoy y'all Sunday. And I think I'm it. This is it for today. Except for, you know, I have to review the Housewives of Atlanta. They come on at 8 p.m., I'll be doing that for y'all. But then I'll be done close it out. And I'll probably done made some pre-recorded videos that y'all will see during the week. But this is it. I got one more post in this. Like I said, that's the Real Housewives of Atlanta. That's coming on Sunday unless they postpone that too. They just said the reunion here. They ain't saying nothing about Sunday. You know, that's already been pre-recorded. So we'll see what it do. But other than that, y'all like the video, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. To our channel, I should say, okay, because if it's no me without you, and I ain't like Queen Elizabeth, I ain't gonna hell leaving y'all all, you know, not telling y'all I ain't going nowhere. I'm gonna tell y'all we in trouble, we got to go, okay, and then you don't hear from me no more, okay. But at least Dale came to the house and told y'all better get y'all shit straight. You're trying to put us in bunkers, you're trying to kill us out, I'm gone, you know what I'm saying. And that's how I roll, okay? I say, if you see me moving real fast, you know you better get on out the way, and you probably better follow me, because I'm getting out the danger zone, all right? But that's all I got to say. Love you all to the core, and I'll see y'all next video. See you later.